All right. Good deal. Just a couple of announcements. Operation Christmas Child. They got 2,266 shoeboxes this year. That's 230 more than they did last year. So those of you that participated in that, that's an awesome, awesome thing to go there. Angel Tree. We still have one. Do we have the boy or the girl left? We have one left, and if you would like to do Angel Tree, we have the two-year-old boy. We have a two-year-old boy that needs stuff for Christmas, and if that is you, oh, so Derry, Tennyson will hook you up right after church then, okay? So that takes care of that. Wonderful. We are done with that. Those of you that do not know, you can pray for Heather and James. Heather's father passed away here, was it Thursday? And it's kind of a freak accident and stuff, what happened with him and stuff. So if you just pray for them, the service I think is Monday. So we would pray for those guys, if you would. And how many of you were here last week? Right on. You know, there was a little short dude up here last week. Yeah. kind of handsome, huh? I got to watch it. I went to pull it up Sunday morning. I was in California. Went to pull it up Sunday morning, and he had asked Brian to put something on the video part of it, and YouTube blocked it. And I'm like, so I'm calling Brian. I'm calling Cowboy. Hey! But I finally got to watch it. It was awesome. He did an awesome job, and that's probably not the last time you will hear from him. So, God is good. I had a blast in California. We had a reunion with our Israel crew, and all 27 of us that went made it. And we actually FaceTimed our guide at the same time, so we had Israel and everybody all going on at the same time. We had a blast down there, so just some really good stuff. Got to hang out with Iceman and his men's group on Tuesday night, and he's got this, I don't know if anybody's familiar with California, the Stockton, Lodi gangster area, right in that area. That's where he does his men's group, and there's some really cool dudes that come to that meeting. And had six guys that are learning how to box. Their mentor now is bringing them in to teach them how to box to get them off the street. And just some cool things going on down there too. So thanks for praying for me. Thanks for supporting Mikey last week. And away we go. You're on, sir.
All right, please join me in our set free pledge. Well, it's quiet in here. All right, time to light her up, all right? I am part of the fellowship of the unashamed. I have Holy Spirit power. The die has been cast. I've stepped over the line. The decision has been made. I'm a disciple of Jesus. I won't look back or let up, slow down, back away, or be still. My past is redeemed. My present makes sense. My future is secure. I'm finished and done with low living, sidewalking, cheap giving, and dwarf goals. I no longer need preeminence, prosperity, position, promotion, or popularity. I don't have to be right, recognized, praised, regarded, or recorded. I live by faith, walk by patience. My face is set, my gate is fast, my goal is heaven, my road is narrow, my way is rough, my companions are few. My guide is reliable, my mission is clear. I cannot be bought, compromised, deterred, hired away, turned back, deluded, or delayed. I will not flinch in the face of sacrifice or hesitate in the presence of the enemy. I will not give up, shut up, let up until I've stayed up, prayed up. I will give till I drop, preach till all I know, and work till he stops me. And when he comes, my banner will be clear. Amen. Very groovy to see you guys tonight. I know we're butting heads with the Parade of Lights, but I think we'll be the Parade of Lights when we walk out of here tonight. Amen? How's that? So if you'd bow your heads with me, we're there you go, cup. Cup's got a light. All right. Now we want to make Jesus shine. Amen? So if you bow your heads with me, we're going to bring tonight's offering. Father God, Lord, we truly thank you for this blessing as we get to gather. We get to gather and worship a mighty God. A God that takes care of us. A God that provides. A God who is always with us. Father God, tonight as we give, I just pray tonight we give knowing who is the light that's in us. Because he lives and he wishes to shine through you. So we give tonight because we're going to shine. And we want to give and pray and worship in the mighty name of Jesus. And that's the name we're going to worship tonight. Amen? Amen.
How y'all doing tonight? Tanya's visiting her mother, who's 90.
And her daughter.
And her daughter.
She made it to California today.
In California. This week and next week. So pray for them, and I guess you have to put up with us. I was thinking about praise and worship tonight, and, you know, really the whole thing needs to start with what favorite songs of mine do we want to play tonight, right? Is that... That's not it? Okay. That's not it. And I always, every time I have to come up with a list, I have to stop, I have to drop and roll and take care of, you know, business mentally, spiritually, and go, you know, God, we really want you to be glorified, but we don't want to just wish it so. We really, God, we really want to see you clear enough to where we're just responding. Is he worthy? Amen. Are you guys ready to worship? Okay, I have absolutely no reason whatsoever to hope to get into heaven at all, except for the blood of Jesus Christ.
Giver of every breath I breathe, author of all eternity, giver of every perfect thing, to you be the glory. Maker of heaven and of earth, no one can comprehend your worth. King over all the universe, to you be the glory. And I'm alive because I'm alive in you. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. And it's all because of the blood of Jesus Christ that covers me and raised this dead man alive. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. I'm alive. I'm alive.
Giver of every breath.
Giver of every breath I breathe. Author of all eternity. Giver of every perfect thing. To you be the glory. Maker of heaven and of earth, no one can comprehend your worth. King over all the universe, to you be the glory. And I'm alive because I'm alive in you. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. And it's all covers me and raise this dead man to life. And it's all because of Jesus. Every sunrise
your praise. The universe cries out your praise. I'm singing freedom all my days now that I'm alive. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. And it's all because of the blood of Jesus Christ that covers me and raised this dead man's life. And it's all because of Jesus. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. And it's all because of the blood of Jesus Christ that covers me and raised this dead man's life. And it's all because of Jesus I'm alive. I'm alive. I'm alive. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we praise you tonight. You are worthy. Thank you. Thank you, God, for all of the stuff that you're worthy for, that we know about, for all of the stuff that you're worthy of, that we'll only learn about in eternity. We give you glory tonight in Jesus' name.
From everlasting to everlasting, secure through culture shifting sand, unchanged by all the vanities of man. And as the nations rise and fall, your sovereignty remains, because you are. Through times of turbulence, adopting those who call upon your name, hallelujah. And every generation joins in song of grateful praise, because you are,
you are,
you are,
you are,
oh, you are the one true God.
Eternal,
eternal,
eternal.
Invisible God.
Again, eternal, immortal, invisible. Doubt it.
That's just the way it is. You are God alone from before time began. You were on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God. You're the only God whose power none can contend. You're the only God whose name and praise will never end. You're the only God who's worthy of everything we can give. You are God, and that's just the way it is. You are God alone. Before time began, you were on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne. You are God alone. You are God alone. From before time began, you're unshakable, you're unstoppable, that's what you are. You're unchangeable, you're unshakable, you're unstoppable, that's what you are.
Unchangeable,
you're unchangeable, you're unshakable, you're unstoppable, that's what you are. You're unchangeable, you're unshakable, you're unstoppable, that's what you are. You are God alone, from before time began, you are on your God alone, and right now, in the good times and bad,
You are on your throne. You are God alone.
Praise you, Jesus. God, we need you so bad. In the middle of this time, when we're here, freed up from all the distractions, we need you. And when we're in the middle of the battle and we're dealing with it, we need you, God. Help us to realize, as we need you, you're there for us. We praise you in Jesus' name.
My refuge is
always, always.
Father, we just thank you that you come through always, 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 Father. Lord, we praise you tonight, Lord, that you are the glory and the lifter of our heads, Father God. Lord, that you're so faithful and gracious to us. Lord, when we stumble and fall, Lord, you are quick to pick us up, Lord. Your hands are always outstretched, seeking us, Lord, when we're not seeking you, Lord. You sought us first, Father God. We thank you for the blood of the cross, Lord, that cleanses us and makes us new. Lord, you are the healer. Lord, you are our restorer, our salvation, Lord. You are our all in all, our strength in the time of trouble. Lord, you are our all in all, Father God. You are always there, Father. Lord, to pick us up when we fall down. Lord, we thank you for tonight, Lord, that we can trust in you, Lord, without fail, Lord, that there's nothing that we cannot trust you for. Lord, you go before us in the presence of our enemies and make a table. Lord, you rejoice over us with singing. Lord, we thank you tonight, Lord. That, Lord, as your word comes, Lord, let it come alive in us. Let your word be alive in us, Lord. Even at the beginning, Lord, when you said, let us be the light that goes out. Lord, there's a light of praise. Lord, let your glory, Lord, light us up, Lord, that our lights would shine before men, Lord, that they would see our good deeds, Lord, and that you would be glorified in our lives, Lord. We surrender this all to you, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you the honor and the glory, Lord. And declare that you are our righteousness. Lord, you are our high tower. You are our refuge, Lord. Whatever we're going through tonight, Father God, I pray, Lord, that our eyes would be on you, Lord. That it would be not on ourselves, Lord. That our eyes be focused on you, Lord. You said to seek you first in the kingdom of God. And, Lord, everything else will be added to us. Lord, that there's nothing that's impossible with you. Praise you for it in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Right on. Right on. Right on. Now take a quick glance up here. Besides Sonia, notice anything different up front here? There's no women up here. Holy cow, how did that happen? Wow. You don't see too many praise and worship crews and all that stuff where it's all guys, and they did pretty well for just being a bunch of dudes up there, you know what I mean? Amen. So what are you thankful for? How was your Thanksgiving dinner? Was it awesome? Do what? Rolled away. Yeah, we had somebody that should have probably rolled away, but no. I got a couple guys around here that know how to eat, you know what I mean? So tell me, what are you thankful for?
All my family.
All your families. Thankful for Jesus. Sobriety. God's word. Somebody else said something.
State of Montana.
State of Montana. What'd you say?
The cross.
The cross. His strength. His strength. Holy Spirit. Health. Until you're not doing very well, health is good. You know what I mean? Somebody else said something.
Love.
For your wife. Peace, grace. Mercy. Chocolate. You know, there's nothing wrong being thankful for chocolate. Now, can we round this all up in one whole thing, though, is God's created each and every one of us in his image and his likeness, right? So we need to be thankful to God for everything that you just mentioned. Because without him, none of that stuff would be there. You know, I always hear people say, well, I'm thankful for my wife, I'm thankful for my kids. That's true, but who gave you your wife and your kids? Now, some of you are thinking, well, the devil did, but no, that's not true. If you would change that and say, God, thank you for the wife or husband you gave me, your marriage might start turning around. You think that's funny, but I'm telling you, there's some people that say, I think the devil hooked us up. Well, I'll guarantee you the devil didn't hook you up. You might have made some bad choices. But even in amongst the bad choices, God can take that and flip it around and make it not just good, not just better. He can make it really, 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 really awesome. I can't think of a better word. So super fantastic, super delicious, stupendous, all that good stuff. Amen? Well, last Saturday, Nona dropped me off at the airport at about 6 o'clock, and usually in the airport she just kicks me to the curb and says, I love you, see you when you get back, and I go in and get all my stuff, get ready to get on the plane and all that stuff. I won't say usually, 99% of the time, I never bring a bag that I have to check. I always bring carry-on stuff, so I'm on and off and away I go. So get all my stuff sitting up in the airport just waiting, and we're waiting, and we roll out the plane, and we all load onto the plane and fire the plane up, and you're seeing all these guys coming and going. Like, whoo, wonder if they're waiting for somebody. Then all of a sudden they come on the thing and says, don't want to freak anybody out, but the lights are all going to go out. We need to shut the plane down and reboot the computer or whatever. DJ, help me out here. Okay, so we sit down there. All the generators, everything. Whoosh, boosh. We're all sitting there, and people are kind of, you can tell people are nervous because you get that, those people start going, ha ha, yeah. Oh, yeah. And I'm just laughing. I'm praying, laughing, and they're, oh, man. Ooh. And then all of a sudden you hear, whoop, everything comes back on. Guys coming and going again. Stewardess gets on the thing. I'm sorry to tell you, but this plane isn't going anywhere. We've got some malfunction somewhere. They're going to shut it down. You all need to disembark, take all your carry-on luggage with you. So we all disembark. We're sitting, hanging out. And I'm telling you, I'm going to talk about thankfulness tonight. And you know what? I was supposed to be in Sacramento, California at 10:30. Our plane didn't leave Great Falls till 10:30. Because they had to fly a plane from Seattle with the mechanic out to get this plane. And then I had not only go to Seattle, from Seattle, I was supposed to go to Sacramento. I had to go to Seattle, then to Portland, then to Sacramento. And so I got into Sacramento about 7 o'clock that night. But the cool thing about it is, if you will be thankful to God for everything that happens, God will always, and I'm going to say this, people say, well, you can't say always. Yes, I can, because you're not looking if you don't see it. God will always bring somebody to talk to you or for you to be able to share what's going on in your life. I had that everywhere I went. Wow. It started in Gray Falls talking to a guy. Then pulled into Seattle, and then Portland, I was a little bit miffed, I'll be honest. Pulled into Portland thinking, why, oh, we got stuff in Portland. I could have went straight to Sacramento and been there. And I get off Portland, get on the plane, and here's a college girl flying home to Sacramento and is in a world of hurt. And guess who's sitting next to her? Now, I don't line that stuff up. God lines that stuff up. And we're sitting there, and you know, us guys know when you girls have a problem.
No.
I got 5 women in my life. I know when something's going haywire with one of you ladies. And so we're sitting there, and she's trying to do. I said, how you doing? Fine. Oh. Really? Actually, she was sitting right here. I said, really, girlfriend? And when I called her girlfriend, she just kind of gave me that look. And I said, well, I got daughters your age. And I said, I told her my little story of my 5 women in my life and all that stuff. And she kind of looked at me a little bit, and I said, you know, life's never so bad that things can't get worked out. And we got to share all the way, well, not all the way, it's a flight, Portland to Seattle, you're almost up and then down. But you just got to share with her, and as she was getting off, she's got her backpack heading out, and she just turned around and just said, you know, thank you. And so I had to go to Portland to meet that one girlfriend. And that's what stopped the 3 hours in the airplane in Great Falls, because I would have never went to Portland if I'd have been on time to Seattle, Sacramento, and I never went to Portland, and I never would have met that girl. Any of you get pissed when things go wrong? Oh, you're all lying. There's only a few people telling the truth here. When things don't go our, I'll just lay it all on me. When things don't go my way, I get a little fâché. I'm learning as we're doing this and we're walking this out and all this stuff that people speak things into my life. People challenge me in my life. And usually when somebody in a place of authority or somebody over me speaks into my life and I don't like what they speak, anybody with me get a little mad? Yeah. Well, who are they to talk? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Ephesians chapter 5. And I'm going to burn through some scriptures here tonight real fast. Hopefully, I'm going to make it. Ephesians chapter 5. Starting in verse 15, says this. Be very careful then how you live. Not as unwise, but as wise. Making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand what the Lord's will is. Do not get drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Spirit, speaking to one another with psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. Sing and make music from your heart to the Lord, always. Come on, help me out. Always.
Amen.
To God the Father for a couple things. No, giving thanks to God the Father for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We're supposed to give thanks to God for
everything.
How can that work? Why can't it? That's a good thing right there. Why can't it work? You think it has something to do with mine and your attitudes? Mm-hmm. If I'm copping an attitude, do you think I'm right ready to give thanks for everything? Not a chance. I don't know what possessed me that Saturday morning up there, but it was just, in fact, right when I was making that video that you guys watched last week, it was God was just hammering me. Just be thankful. Be thankful. Be thankful. I don't want to be stinking thankful. I had to pay $10 for a stinking sandwich. Ham, the cheese was cold. I asked her to nuke it again. It was still cold. And it was just like, shut up, JT, just eat it. Okay. Be thankful in everything. Here's one of my, I give this verse all the time, 1 Thessalonians 5. I've asked you guys many times before, what's God's will for you? We're going to read it real quick again. 1 Thessalonians 5. 16, 17, and 18 says, rejoice. Come on, rejoice.
Always.
Pray.
Always.
Give thanks in most circumstances.
Always.
Give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. This is God's will for me in Christ Jesus. We're supposed to give thanks in Ephesians 5 said we're supposed to give thanks for everything. So I think everything and all things covers pretty much
everything.
The whole works. Colossians chapter 2. Colossians chapter 2 and verse 6 says, "So then, just as you receive Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in Him, rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, overflowing with thankfulness." Woo! Can I put this a different way? Can you imagine if this bunch of people right here walked out of here tonight, and for, I'm not even going to try a week. Let's try one day. Let's not even try one day. Let's try a half a day. Walked out of here, and for one half a day, we were nothing but thankful for everything. Wow. People would be looking at you like you're on something. Did you slip again? You crash and burn? And you using what? No, yeah, I'm using. I'm using Jesus. Can I challenge you? Now, I'm not going to challenge you tomorrow because tomorrow is football. And of course, as long as we win, we're thankful. But let's think about Monday when we head off to work or we head off to school. First thing, your eyes pop open and you just say, you know, Lord, thank you. Thank you for life. Thank you for the breath. Thank you if you got your wife with you or your husband with you. Thank you for my spouse. Thank you for my kids. Thank you for my post-toasties. Thank you for the coffee. Thank you for the water running out of the sink that I can brush my teeth, shave my face, take a shower. You know what? If you start thinking about everything you can be thankful for, it's amazing. Thank you for I got a roof over my head. Amen. Thank you I got clothes to put on. Thank you I got clean socks in my sock drawer. Thank you. You know, think about this. As you're rolling out, you know, and thankful that you got a car or a truck or a bike or whatever you're, and if you don't have that, thank God that you got feet that you can walk to work. Hello? Thank God that there's a bus that'll come by and pick you up and take you to work. If we would get into the thankful mode, I know my attitude changes when I'm like that. Because the enemy will just bombard me with negativity, bombard me with people saying different things, bombard me with this, bombard me with that, and it's like, no! I'm even thankful that there's people that are haters, because if we didn't have the haters, how would we know how to love people? Now there's a tricky one there. Hello? It's easy to love somebody that loves you. Come on, you never even think about it. But it's when them people are talking crap about you that's when you got to learn to be thankful for the haters, because God's teaching you how to love those people. Amen? The boss calls you into the office Monday. You need to be thankful you have a boss. Need to be thankful you have a job. You know, quit complaining about your job. Be thankful for your job. My wife beat me over the head tons of times when I was at the fire department. I used to call it the rock mine. The rock mine. Or was it a rock pit? I'm headed to the rock pit. I really thought I was going to get out of there a long, long time ago before I retired. I thought God was going to pull me out and put me into somewhere where there was a bunch of Christians. Thank God he didn't do that. You ever worked with a bunch of Christians? I'm just saying. I've never met so many angry, peed off, mad at the world, got screwed, all about me people in my whole life. Come on, you're laughing, but there's that nervous laugh again. That's like the people sitting in that airplane when the lights went out. Because it's true. When we should be the most grateful, joyful, thankful, smiling people on the planet. Flip over to Colossians chapter 3. Colossians is a good book if you want to read through here and teaches you how to live for Christ. Colossians chapter 3, starting in verse 15, says, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts." You know, if you have peace, you pretty much got it. True? If there's peace in your life, peace in your heart, you've pretty much got it whipped. You can walk into a situation and there's no peace. Oh my gosh. I can always look down at my Fitbit and say, whew, my heartbeat's going. My heartbeat's great at telling me if I'm at peace or not. You walk into a bad situation and you look down and your heartbeat's at 70, or my heartbeat's at 70, I'm doing pretty good. Now, if I look down there and it's 110, I'm in trouble, Maddie. Let the peace of Christ rule your heart, since as members of one body, we're all one body, you are called to peace. And we're supposed to be? Oh my gosh, here's that word again. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit. We just read that a little bit ago too. Singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through Him. Everything we do, what's coming out of your mouth? Words, but what kind of words? Are we edifying people? Are we lifting people up? Are we speaking good stuff? Are we speaking trash? Just asking. When the Holy Spirit convicts me, when I start, and I love to joke and play. She's raising both eyebrows at me right now. And sometimes I get to joking and playing too much. And her eyebrows go just like that at me. My words are more likely not being edifying in my joking and playing. Anybody in there? You get to joking and playing and horsing around and doing some stuff and we go across the line. I pray all the time that their Holy Spirit walks around with a big 4x4 all the time. Because 2x4s don't usually get my attention. I need a big one. And when I start messing around or saying some things that I shouldn't say, I'm trying to get, and man, I'm telling you what, this is probably the hardest thing I've ever done in my entire life, is constantly think positive, even in amongst the negative. How does that work? When I got people coming up and saying, this is going on, that's going on. And I got to say, okay, now how do I put a positive spin to that? And this is, I'm going to tell you what I got to do with certain instances is I have to say, okay, God, I give thanks that you created them because they're made in the image and likeness of Jesus Christ also, right? So even somebody that's talking trash about you or hating on you is still made in the image of Christ. And do you think he loves them? Absolutely.
So, help me, Jesus, help me, Jesus, help me, Jesus, help me, Jesus. Thank God that you created them for this time right now, that I can learn how to pray for someone who's not being loved by other people. Because, you know, hurt people hurt people. Let me say that one more time. Some of you didn't get that. People who are hurt will hurt other people. Because they don't know any different. They're hurt, so they're going to lash out at somebody else. I'm getting close. Got to go here. Turn to Colossians chapter 4. Right next door. Well, I knew I was getting close. Verse 2 says this. Colossians 4, 2. It says, devote yourselves. And then I got a little side note. It says, be steadfast, diligent to prayer. Being watchful and thankful. So what are we supposed to do? We're supposed to be diligent. We're supposed to be devoted to prayer. And we're supposed to be... Yeah, but what are we doing first? Watchful. We're watching what's going on around us and being thankful for the situations we're in. Whew. God brought some meathead people into your lives for purpose. I'm dead serious. I finally figured this out. Because I was always trying to get away from meatheads. Hello, I'm probably the biggest one around. But I was always trying to dodge and get away from that. But God brings people into your life for a purpose. And one of those purposes is to let show them the love of Christ, even when they're trashing you. You ever been thankful when somebody's talking crap about you? Oh, well, just thank you for that. I had somebody on Facebook a while back. What was it? Oh, I put something on there about Harvest Party. And talking about all the stuff on Harvest Party on there. And somebody put on there, Christians need to come up with another name for Harvest Party. That's just whatever. I put, thanks for the encouragement. What are you going to do? You ain't going to change their mind. I'm not going to change their mind. Hello? Man. Just love on people. Last scripture, maybe. Hebrews. I'm throwing that out there every now so I don't lie anymore. Hebrews 12. In verse 28. Says, therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken. Jesus Christ's kingdom is not going to be shaken. Let us be thankful and so worship God acceptably with reverence and awe, for our God is a consuming fire. Woo! We need to be... Oh, come on, you've been sitting here for 20 minutes? We need to be... in everything, in all circumstances. If you don't get nothing out of tonight, except one thing. And I pray the Holy Spirit wakes you up. Middle of the night. I got woke up at 12:12 the other night. And you ever, in the middle of the night, you get woke up. You just, it's not like you wake up and go, oh, I got to go to the bathroom and go stumble out of bed. I got woke up. I went, boom. And I'm like, did I hear something in the house? So I'm listening. Don't hear it. So I get up, walk all through the house. Nothing going on. Lay back down in bed. Maybe I'm supposed to pray. Okay. So I'm praying in the spirit, just praying, praying, praying. And usually that works for me. Devil usually knocks me right out when I start praying. So I'm thinking, I got this made. I'm just praying away, and I look over at the clock. and it's quarter after one. Okay, I'm going to pray some more. And at the end of this whole thing, I got one thing. I need to be thankful that God can wake me up and talk to me. Now, don't ask me what he said, because we never got on that. I kept asking all the time, what are we doing? You ever ask God questions and don't get answers? He's got a purpose for something, just didn't know what it was. So I said, okay, I'm thankful. And I just fell asleep, I think, and the dogs got up. Do you know when God teaches you something? It's just like school. When you get taught something, what does the teacher bring you at the end of the week? There's a test to see if you learned what the teacher taught you. So us Christians, us passionless followers of Jesus Christ, why do we get upset when we get tests? We fail them all the time. I fail them all the time. I'm probably setting you guys up for a miserable week. I probably am. I really am. Because now you're going to have meatheads. You're going to have challenges. You're going to have people. And you're going to have to be thankful for them and pray for them. And when you come back next Saturday, don't shoot the messenger. I really do love you, though. And you know what? We need to get out of our Christianese shells. Hello? And we need to be the passionate followers and act, walk, talk like Jesus. We're great at being Christians right here. Hello? Woo! I'm just on fire, lit up for Jesus. As soon as I step out the door, oh, man. So here's your challenge for the week. Even if your football team loses tomorrow, you're going to have to be happy. So I'm just going to pray for all of us. And the sad thing about it is I know when I teach stuff or say stuff like this, I know I'm going to get smoked this week. I really am. I know it. And all of it's going to be because it's a test of the emergency broadcast system. The little peacock, remember the little peacock on that thing? Come on. Woo! And you're waiting for that thing to stop. Woo! And the thing's scrolling across the bottom. Woo! This is a test of the emergency broadcast. Woo! Please don't change your channel. Woo! This is only a test. Woo! You're going to have fun this week. Amen?
Amen?
Bow your heads with me. Father God, in Jesus' name, we are so thankful to you for everything that you've given us, everything you've provided for us. And Lord, I just pray that the mind and heart that you've given each and every one of us, Father, that we would have the mind and heart of Jesus Christ this week. And no matter what happens, no matter what is said, no matter what comes at us, Father, that we can be thankful for everything. We can be thankful in all circumstances. And we just keep right on praying continually. Lord, I thank you for your word. And I just thank you that you're in charge of everything. And you're in control of everything. And I think you made a mistake when you gave us free will. But you even knew what you were doing then. So, Father, I pray that the Holy Spirit leads us, guides us, encourages us, strengthens us, and kicks us this week when we need it, Father God, that we can be the people you've created us to be in Christ and through Christ Jesus to touch a hurt, dying, and miserable world. Father, let them see the love of Jesus Christ pour forth from each and every one of us. Let our words be encouraging. Let our words be edifying. And let us just stay lit up and on fire for Jesus Christ this week. I pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I love you. Remember to be thankful. See you next week.